Hello everyone, hi and welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, Capital Expenditure Formula, watch the video till the end, and also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, and today's topic is Capital Expenditure Formula. Let's try and understand this in a detailed format, what exactly this formula is all about. It's basically an accounting formula. And capital expenditure is basically a part of assets. So when the capex is basically added, it has been comprised as a part of the assets. Let's understand this in a detailed format. Now, what is capex? Capex is basically your net increase in your property, plants and equipments. That is your PPE plus your depreciation expenses. So it's net increase in the PPE plus depreciation expense. Let's understand this in a detailed format with the help of an example. Now, first and the foremost thing, the capital expenditure formula, it calculates what? The total purchase of the assets by the company in the given fiscal year. And it can be easily found by adding a net increase in PPE value during the year to its depreciation expense for the same year. So, what is going to be the formula? The capex formula is going to be your net increase in PPE plus your depreciation expenses. So here the net increase in the PPE during the year can be calculated by deducting the PPE at the beginning of the year from the PPE value minus the PPE at the end of the year. So that will be the net increases. So beginning minus end will give you the increase, right? So how we can derive this? The net increase in PPE is going to be PPE at the beginning, or you can say actually it should be end minus at the beginning of the year. Now, on the other hand, if you see the depreciation expense over here, this part, the depreciation expense during the year can be calculated by deducting the accumulated depreciation at the beginning, okay, depreciation, or I'll say at the end of the year minus accumulated depreciation at the beginning of the year, right? So, the formula of capex goes something like this. It is PPE at the end minus PPE at beginning. Okay, this is the first part, plus accumulated depreciation at the end. Okay, minus accumulated depreciation at the beginning. As simple as that, right? So this is the whole formula. Let's understand this with the help of a step-by-step approach for a better understanding. The steps to calculate capex. Now, the step one is, firstly, the PPE value at the beginning of the year and the end of the year is collected from the asset side. The first value is collected from the asset side of the balance sheet, and the net increase in the PPE value is calculated by deducting at the beginning from the end. So, step two. The next is the accumulated depreciation at the beginning of the year and end of the year is collected from the balance sheet. Net accumulated depreciation at beginning is collected from the balance sheet, and then the depreciation expense during the year is calculated by deducting the accumulated depreciation at the end minus beginning of the year. Conversely, you can also say that these depreciation expenses incurred during the year can also be directly be collected from the income statement, okay, where it is captured as a separate line item. So depreciation expense is equal to the accumulated depreciation at the end of the year. Accumulated depreciation at the end of the year minus accumulated depreciation at the beginning of the year. finally, the step 3 is just to calculate the capex, right? Our formula, as simple as that. So, let's get to an example to understand this topic with some numbers. Let's crunch some numbers. Let us take the example of a company ABC Limited and calculation of capital expenditure based on some of the following information which I'm going to specify. Let's say the depreciation expense is 10,500 in the income statement. Then the PPE at the end of the year 20 is, let's say, 45,500. And at the beginning of the year, let's say it is 40,000. Therefore, the net increase in the PPE value is going to be how much? It's end minus beginning, that is 5,500, and depreciation, right? So my capex will be how much? Well, it is your net increase in the PPE and the depreciation, that is your capital expenditure. Let's take, this is just a simple example which I had quoted. Let me take a little one more complicated one to make this a good way of understanding. Let us take an example of Apple Inc. Everyone have heard about Apple. And the calculation of the capital expenditure, let's say in 2017 and 2018. Let's take it as the net PPE at the opening. Let's say 33,783. And 27,010. We'll consider this as millions. Everything is in millions, okay? Net PPE, this will be closing. Okay? So, when we're talking about closing, let's say 41,304, 33,783. Then we have the depreciation at, accumulated depreciation at the opening value, that is the beginning of the year, 41,293 and 34,235. Finally, depreciation closing, which will be 49,099 and 41,293. So the net increase in the PPE is how much? Net PPE is gonna be your closing minus the opening, right? So this is the net increase in 2017. Okay, in the similar fashion, let's take for depreciation, closing minus opening, and in the similar fashion here, 7058. So my capex will be for both the years is 13,831, right? So, I hope you have got a fantastic idea from this particular topic. Finally, let me make you understand the relevance and use of this formula. See, the capex formula is used for calculating the total purchase of assets that is made by the company during the given period of time. And it is calculating by adding the net increase in the value of the plant, property and equipment and the depreciation expenses during the particular fiscal year. See, the understanding of the capex is very important from the point of view of the business, since it is usually very expensive, and especially for the companies who are in the manufacturing sector. So, these kind of capex signify the fund that it is being utilized by a company for a purchase of improvement of long-term assets with an intention to improve the production capacity of the company. So, a capex formula basically offers the potential to reap benefits in the future as a part of the long-term strategic goal. However, you need to note here something, that the biggest challenge that is associated with the decision of the capital expenditure is that it cannot be undone in the future without incurring losses given the huge initial outlay. So, as such, wrong capital expenditure can be completely detrimental to the company's growth. Nevertheless, the capital expenditure has to be incurred either in the form of new setup or for the upgradation, simple, of the existing setup in order to ensure that the company is operating with the state-of-the-art technology. And it is to be noted that if the capital expenditure incurred during the year is higher, I'm saying if the capex is, let's say, higher than the depreciation expense during the year, then it indicates growing asset base of the company. Otherwise, it is shrinking asset base of the company. Well, that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again for joining the session. Cheers.